This program is rated 13, recommended for family viewing.
Wednesday right here in the land of Kampala, and of course another day to wake up and look forward to achieving all your successes and goals that you have set out to achieve. This is the 7th of August 2019, another beautiful version of Urban Today. My name is Derek Ayanadasha, and of course being a Wednesday, that means that we do have a couple of days until the week gets to say goodbye. What have you set out for, and have you achieved any of that before we say goodbye to the weekend? But moving on from that, Gina Fies and Willis definitely joining me up on this one as usual till the hour of 11 a.m. Good morning to you guys.
I'm in a good mood today. I'm just in a good mood.
That's good.
Like I'm walking on sunshine.
That's
like
good.
People need to understand happiness is a choice. Poverty is a state of mind. I can keep going. I want to be a motivational speaker.
Well done.
Lol.
Yeah. For me, I'm in a good mood, and for Sasas, you know, I'd like to crush on a friend of mine, very good chubby woman, very, very joyful woman. You know, she walks around and I'm like, oh, wow, you have a very wonderful life. Her happiness is affectionate. Should I say affectionate?
Infectious.
It's magnetic. Infectious, yes. That's not an, you know, imigiwu. Immaculate giwu.
I thought Lynn.
Lynn is for next week, but this week is immaculate giwu.
And in a car schedule.
I have a schedule. For who to crush on today, tomorrow, the other day. So for me today, I'm crushing on Immaculate Giwu.
I thought rich people
have joyful, so it was not an arrangement.
She was looking for the remote to tune into Urban.
Really?
When watch Urban.
No, it wasn't. It wasn't. You know, I just saw in the morning, you know, usually when I say in the morning, she just comes up and she just spreads.
She just spreads
this happiness around
you. She just
you,
has that positive
she's
vibe.
Like, gamba chibi chionde de kachai jangu na kona 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 kuyuya. Neoba wa fili dua.
Ogayo.
Tukanoga image. Chufu na fili dua na happiness jumpa de ya mani. Such people around us are what, you
they are very important.
Yeah.
And and like they always say, watch the company you keep. The people you surround yourself with affect you directly in ways you don't understand.
Yes.
If you chill with very gloomy people, hi Nicholas Robovi. If you
Is he the one who chills with gloomy people, or he's the gloomy one?
Oh, then, but then you come out example. Oh, yeah, ingi demu bo ingi.
Neither for me, Immaculate is one of those people. Ever since I met her, of course, there are some few times. Yeah, that the times when you see her.
I actually went to school with her, and she was always like that.
The times you see her, Bambi, and she has some kasad issue going around. But you know, most of the time since I met her,
she's happy.
Chick has always been excited.
Whatever you want from you this
there
morning.
Is nothing I want from. I'm just crushing on her happy.
No, I said, let it come to pass, hey. My son.
About Jack Office, you know, Ve Wakanga, we're not going
to go away. Oh,
yeah. Yeah. Mulutalo, no, Jan, not to Zimbira face, you know, to Zimba Kobuyumba. But now you know, you give him a new vision. I just want to come to be happy. But on the other note, I'm very disappointed in politicians. Who have decided to spin a very sad story,
for their own gain.
I'm very disappointed.
Very good morning until that conversation broke out.
I know, like...
Yeah, and then you started fighting with everyone.
Like I said, the energies around us, they affect you.
Listen, now they're very disappointed. I wish that if the guy had died, bali lese police nekolo guayo. Police nefulimia report, netuweka taniko jikuwa mwe vituli.
True.
But now, you know, the guy dies and everyone, yeah, lakuma badako la wati, lakuma badako la wati. But now, yomu tutafako.
No, my issue is, my problem is, wana itulekera extensionalizing abulichim. The other day, I was on Facebook, and two adult grown men, walua uliwa ya ita Boston, biyako zebitia, are on social, throwing threats, at people who are in this country and trying to say we have a movement. And I'm looking at these two grown men and I'm like, first of all, you are screaming foul while you're in a white man's land. Stop coming to social media, take a damn flight. Come fight. Since you say you want to fight, you're fighting. Take a flight. Don't buy data. No. Muja muchirwanire wano. You people are spreading so much hate over something that can actually be very small.
Over nothing.
Over nothing, actually.
There's not, because what threats are over what?
Like, so you know
what it is.
You're in Trump land, you're earning in dollars, you have homes here, you have family here.
Everyone has a way they see life. Mm. So if you see your nyigirizi dwa, you in a dembeli okuganti.
This conversation, you know, some politicians going over on social media and, you know, turning a very sad story into, you know, tarnishing the entire government's name and them coming out to say that, you know, during the eras of President Museveni, these are the things that used to happen. And literally what they're trying to polish out there is the fact that, you know, our very own, you know, Ziggy Wine has something to do with, you know, the government and politics that was being played that led to his loss of lives. You know, something very tragic like that.
Yeah, very tragic. At the end of the day, because I saw Bobby Wine quoting Mutawa Museveni, Biawandika, Akula Gengina, Tujiba Tibuane, Insurgency, Aliwo, Naliwoka, Gena, Nalwana. For me, what I learned in that, and I hope that people watching can learn, don't be a pawn in someone's
chess board. This is all a game.
Don't be a pawn. If be at the right place at the right time for the right purpose. Let no politician tell you, jangu tulumbe. Our politician,
everyone has their own agenda.
Baba kagwe, atamanyi kidwa, gwe batamanyi gwe wagendo kubaka banyige.
Gwe wagendo nyiga.
Atama kwa manyi ya manya atano, wakumi gebabali babase kumusolo, nga bantu kalakasa musolo. Bobo wa inagenda, na haba jayo na hawe imidida.
Nende fakwe.
Umusaje ya gamba.
Kamba sese.
Mbana isiku ogeda bubi, elasa ya wantu
mafune bubi. Ketu ogeda bubi.
Nde umusaje ya gamba amunyiga. Amunyiga kidini. Ni bajisandaza umuga kushandaza ni bajisandaza bana banyiga naye agaba
abana banyiga
naye umusaje ari herese
to health anti agenda America.
I mean, the
irony of it, you keep saying every institution in this country has gone to the dogs. Now, yeah, there is not a single politician in this here country. You say the institutions are broken and you're here to change. Musigale Kampala.
But at the end of the day, as young people, as people who are, you know, striving to have a better life. Let's concentrate on making ourselves better. Concentrate on making yourself better. All these guys who are up there first thought about themselves.
That's why they went into what they are
Nebakola haso zaabwe, nebazimba mayumba, katibali munchikola za luxury. So likewise, as you think about
the youth,
earning that extra dollar, saving that extra dollar, and, you know, investing.
And the honest truth is, when I buy youth, they stop being pawns in this game, because each and every one of these people has their own individual wants and likes. That's what he wants. It's his aspiration. What is your
That
is our banter this morning. It seems like it's not been a Wednesday good morning for us. But anyway, at the end of the day, we have to enlighten up and not forget the fact that we have to keep you informed with what is happening within your country. Now, getting into some starting news coming in, we do have some sad news. Apparently, Archbishop Janan Luwum's wife dies. Now, the wife of former Archbishop over the Church of Uganda, Janan Luwum, has died at 90 years of age. Mary Luwum passed on at 3 p.m. at International Hospital Kampala. days after she was diagnosed with adrenal cancer, a rare cancer that begins with one or both of the small adrenal glands located on the top of the kidneys. Miss Foibel-Wom, one of her daughters, said her mother lived her life to the fullest. Miss Luom said yesterday, "My mother was full of life. She was a strong woman. You know, I lost my father at around 8 years, and all I can remember is leaning on my mother and taking me through different stages of life. She struggled bringing up her kids. May her soul rest in eternal peace."
Yes, indeed. Like I always tell people, let's celebrate the lives of the individuals that came and changed so many things about the nation. Move them away into their selfishness. What were about who actually deliberately helped? Move them here, say, these are people we're supposed to be celebrating now. And I know this is something I'm going to say again that chinye giram naye. God forbid if our president died, I would celebrate him. Because he has done something. Let us stop trying to always say these people have not done anything. Celebrate them. Give them their flowers while they are alive.
I think despite the fact that she lost her life yesterday, I would still crush on her this morning.
Yeah.
She's the very best person to crush on at this particular
moment. She also died because she believed it.
Don't even stop.
Let's get into some shout-outs this morning. And of course, my shout-outs are going in all the way to the members of Parliament. Yesterday, we were talking about the sexual offence bill that was tabled before Parliament. And some news coming in from our legislators. Apparently, they could have given it the green light. Now, members of Parliament have approved some sections of the sexual offences bill with the proposal that hands more than 10 years for a person or relative who negotiates a settlement or compromises with a person suspected to have committed a sexual offense. While discussing the bill during a lobby meeting with faith-based organizations and civil society organizations in Mukono at the weekend, the members of parliament under the umbrella organization, the Uganda Women Parliamentary Association, accused the police of abating the behavior of settling sexual offenses out of court. The Kumi municipality member of parliament, Mr. Slias Agon, said we should specifically single out those persons who encourage out-of-court settlements for defilement cases. Girls have suffered at the hands of defilers, only police to release the victims. This is ridiculous. He said girls go through psychological torture and their future is ruined, adding that offenders of such crimes need to be held liable.
Even boys. Some boys,
even boys, not
young
some.
Boys and sexually. But I think it's a good idea that, you know, because there are many people who go around out of sympathy and say, Headmaster, kuto mwana, Headmaster, kaba weyo go ndi mwana kasomere bwerere. That person should also be. I think
because he could do it to the next person.
Yeah,
I call death upon all of them. All of them. All of them. A defiler should never have a second chance at life.
There is a reason why God says
that. And there are people, and a judge. You see, there are people who are falsely accused of sexual offenses. That is why there's a 10-year
I am
term.
Saying the ones that have been found guilty.
And found guilty, you can be found guilty wrongly.
Lol.
That there was not enough evidence. And 3 years later, there's...
Anyway, I'm going to shout out to the Netherlands government. Now, Uganda has received 90 billion from the Netherlands government to equip regional referral hospitals countrywide. The grant will be used to purchase high-tech equipment such as magnetic resonance imaging, that is MRI, machines, x-rays, and ultrasound scans. Health State Minister in charge of general duties, Sarah Opendi, said most of the equipment is obsolete or has broken down. The regional referral hospitals are Arua, Fort Porto, Gulu, Hoima, Jinja, and that's among others. Good thing, man. I'm going to go to the Netherlands. Did you know that everybody there almost is born a millionaire?
In Netherlands?
They pick up APC. You remember the idea we had about the U.S.? Which is a land of all dreams. They don't have big guys. They don't have
friends. Hey.
Mama, I saw a documentary.
Oh, have you seen the worst places in the U.S.?
Mama.
You will cringe. They have places that are worse than our Katanga.
Uganda. Yes. Uganda is the land of dreams, I'm telling you. You just need to know how to find your dreams.
Kari, what do you guy are here? You can get a guy. Boy, you sing and you go home. My shout out this morning is going to the Minister of Energy and Mineral Development. What a wow. How are you guys doing this morning? The government, through the Ministry of Energy and Mineral Development, has set aside 6 billion Uganda shillings to construct a state-of-the-art regional mineral beneficiation center to boost artisanal and small-scale mining in Uganda. The center will be constructed in Rengoma Village, Ruhama sub-county in Tungamo District. Mm. Peter Lokeris, the State Minister of Energy and Mineral Development, who officiated the site handover ceremony on Monday, revealed that the ministry, through the Directorate of Geological Survey and Mines, has set out to construct the regional mineral beneficiation centers in Tungamo, Busia, Moroto, and Fort Poto under the ongoing mineral wealth and mining infrastructure development. He said that it is in line with the government's policy objectives to organize and legislate artisanal and small mining in Uganda. The center will be the first of its kind in Uganda because, as a ministry, we want to provide a framework for marketing and value addition of minerals to promote local content for national participation in the mineral industry. That's according to Lokeris there from the Ministry of Energy and Mineral Development.
Uh-huh. Yes, I think it's a good one. I'm looking forward to
it. It is a good one.
Now imagine, Ozunga, Kasala, Itekana, Kuja, business, Tezinaba, Ingiza, Bulonji, Nuga, Kabaka, Gold, Ngake, Kwese, Kolotia. Wewe ukuda kwa new vision.
Soka ni kubila China. Ndamba China. Ina kizida kwa masaa.
Siriwo.
Chingambile
wili.
Ngambile wili so.
Ne produce.
Ngambile nika. Gida atula mi so.
Ken komewo.
Ngambile nei. Asimu njidja kwa komao. Nsini kala voice note kwa WhatsApp. Sikuwa. Nsini kala voice note kwa WhatsApp. Ningamba. Ah,
bye. Tudamu kula bu selfie mu Seychelles.
Ah. Up in Malibu.
But I think, you know, this is going to be another interesting, you know, opportunity for Ugandans to invest in energy, and miners are getting a lot of, you know, support from the government. So this could be another, you know, a sector for us to invest in apart from the ICT and agriculture. And I think a couple of years from now, we could be ripping.
What do you have aneo ba mining naturally protected? They are killed, they are tortured because of the mines they find, the minerals they find. So I think government needs to step in as well and, you know, protect those small mining places where people are, you know, find like a kilo of gold somewhere.
But do you know? Yeah, Jerry.
So, Kilanga, when we used to have those field trips.
Copper ore. Kilemba is the one with the copper ore, right?
Yeah,
it is, but I don't think it's functional anymore.
Okujanga minerals are guao, never shifting. And then Kilemba mines as the organization is still there. But,
the gold is not yours.
Exactly.
It is for the state.
Who finds out that there is gold?
Even if it is you and you rumor.
Why would I rumor?
No, the fact that you have to take it to smelt it or to get it out of the country, that's already you rumoring.
Where there is a will, there is a way.
Oh,
Namumira mutwali. Wenzo ita mukuma ka gozi, ka airport, neka ogana, neva kwa ambula, neka ogana. Neva leta magnet. Baleta magnet.
Lol.
Rao kwati ya kuchimoto kacha magnet.
We've been watching.
Let us move on, and of course, get into the Press Digest. It is a beautiful midweek, and of course, a couple of news have been making headlines here and outside the country. We have to let you know what is making headlines. As soon as you grab yourself a copy of the new visual, not forgetting Book Ede and the Daily Monitor. Up next is the Press Digest. Alright, looking at the new vision, of course, still there for only 2,000 Ugandan shillings for a hard copy. Down in Kenya, it is, that's of course 107. In Tanzania, it is 1,600. And for the Rand and francs, it is 933. The headline, they're talking about Ziggy Wine, of course, they're saying that he died after the bike accident. This is after the post-mortem that has been carried on by the police. And of course, they're saying that family faces criminal charges. Why is the family facing criminal charges? Details are on page 4. So grab yourself a copy of the new vision. And then, of course, something that has come out of, you know, the one-on-one that has been going on between Eli Tumwine and a couple of other members of parliament. They're saying that allegations are false. This is coming in from Eli Tumwine. And if I'm to quote what he said that these words are meant to tarnish his name. And of course, his career. But more details in case you are following up on this story on the page 6 of today's copy of The New Vision. And another sad story coming in the Mwalimu pullout. Remember, being Wednesday, we take you through the Ministry of Education and some of the things that are happening in the education or teaching sector. Now, apparently, 15 teacher colleges face closure. Details on page 24 and 25. And more sad news coming in is that a couple of teachers will be dropped from their payroll. That's of course looking at 30,000 teachers plus. So get yourself a copy of The New Vision and keep yourself informed with that story. And then of course talking about Arua, terrorism suspects are committed to high court. Hey, grab yourself a copy right there. Mary Luom dies at an age of 90. That's of course another story coming in. And more news coming in from the Minister of Justice. That's of course here in Kampala. That is Major General Kahinda Otafide. He says the government is going to be beefing up security of judicial officers. So grab yourself a copy right there. This comes up after, you know, a bottle was thrown at the Buganda Road. One magistrate, Gladys Musanyo. So grab yourself these details and today's copy of The New Vision. And then, of course, Dutch government gives 90 billion to equip hospitals and a couple of other more interesting news-making headlines in today's copy of The New Vision. Flipping to the backside of some interesting sports right there. They're giving you some of, you know, sports coming in from the local scene. We do have some people are talking about drinking enough water in games is one of the reasons why we won the tournament. Okay, get yourself a copy of The New Vision. And then as well as looking into some racing news for you, motorsport in Kapeka, all that and much more at only 2,000 Ugandan shillings for your hard copy and 1,000 in case you're on the travel and you have the Vision app.
And of course, here's a quick look at your daily monitor for approximately 2,000 shillings too. Now, of course, if you have the student who is in P7, guess what? We have Excel in PLE. You are liars, says General Tumwino as he tells off MPs. Get yourself a copy and find out what has prompted that. Government disqualifies 35,000 teachers. Now, according to audit, thousands to be deleted from the payroll by December as government carries out online registration of all teachers in and out of service across the country. And the drama that was in Luwawa yesterday. Now, MPs and ministry officials were blocked from the hospital side. Get yourself a copy and find out how ridiculous that particular story is. And in your news summary, Ziggy Wine was injured in an accident. That is what the police is saying. And lab technician held over rep of a patient. Archbishop Janani Luwumu's widow is dead. If you flip the pages here and go to sports, Awani highly rated as by Assured Coach. And KCCA players, yes, KCCA is past Wakiso in continental rehearsal. Okello shines in youth takeover at KCCA FC. Get yourself a copy of the Daily Monitor to find out what's happening around you and around the world.
That's very true. What's happening in Bukede?
Bukede, all right. I don't know how to talk about the myth. Tom Mayanje, young man, smiling from Uganda. Can do so many. Tegeka TV yongeleko volume. Wano kupeja yom samfu, abebi jambia, batem yom gaga. Ne mukaziwe wanowe mbagambe na ne mugule mbwa togula bubwa bwa bwa gula mabuja
bagambe baje wa
gule mbwa enyumba
ataina mbwa jangwe wa
enyumba ringa kaso muzita kaso mu luzungu ne wano ujiraba
ne zimu
ne sidaba ya dakabwana akamu gula maguja nga 10 bambi bamulumya nokupeje omusamba ko the story mbukede atak front page okufa kwa Ziggy Wine kukuno peje kubiri kusane yokuna ate wogena ko peje kubiri walikuwa de mubujuvu police biyezude ku Ziggy Wine balikulete de ate Bobby Wine ne banna satu mukaga baba sindise mu koti enkuru emisango bacha lepukana jo mubunji daladala Museveni webale kulwanisa bwavu aliri dawa ayogera nabani gulabuke de omanye ebisinga obwo oyagala ku shopping awe na kasendika akawera bukede bakuteye mu nebyo okugula nemiwendo jayo page 10 agambi bokuta hajati ebombo bamukwatide chitgum hey bana nto omuntu ebombo no jugize chitgum ngenda kudamu okukola ebikompola na muzisa mumpulire
aha
bamwita msajja mukolo Putin, President Putin. Yeah. Minister Meria, bamutadde kubunkenke nga somo kwa muga, uno wana wamsudem bifana nyi mugachi, gulavuke doma hivi singao, te walono mvubi wana studde, owa polisi we mundu, katiniwe unya, ani andi studde munne agawano na wali balese nkola okwagazisa abayizi science bani enkola eri wano bana
sibe twayogera nabo luli
sibe bano balala bano balala nyo mu byemizanyo KCCA etute Revita naweka video ku social media ngaba mu unveiling kumanyu akatulabe banzo waga bagena bakuba akaisanyo ko kugula abazanyia ebungereza akatale akagalawo ncha eza Premier League zetala. Yes.
Wa
Tottenham.
Bana itso Tottenham.
Mulaba uno wano
wa Tottenham.
Era ngabwe.
Tottenham. Tottenham.
But that's all for book and very interesting stories. There ngabwe jomba ga yesonga satu esoka igoli mu Uganda eyo kubiri emboze nyuma nyo ate yo kusatu buke de popular runs 10 zoka zoka. According to the East African, one of the stories they have today is that some 28,000 people are facing serious starvation in South Sudan's Awel State, a minister has said. Those in the rural areas are most at risk. Awel State Minister of Agriculture John Amar Akok added, the Integrated Food Security Phase Classification also said that some 275,000 people have been facing a food crisis between May and July in the same area.
Very sad.
Very sad in South Sudan, Manangi. What to turn the kid your basabi that was a banner to
Sudan.
Abantu they are so hostile towards anyone that goes into
America. Balumba Iraq, Gaba Sudani, Batawa.
Never vaye
Iraq.
Never gained Osama bin Laden.
Never gained Libya. Gaba Sudani, Bafanjara. Mugaba avuddeko abasudani bafanjala
bacharwana
e Kongo chichi Felix azeko abasudani bafanjala
bacharwana
bana chichi people powers
abasudani bafanjala
people power genda
banga bafanjala
batukoma
But anyway, you have it for some of the news to look forward to, especially if you're heading out there to look, you know, for that coin. You definitely need to keep informed with what is happening within and outside the premises of the country. We're going through a very short break, but when we do get back, of course, we'll be getting into our Kachai conversation. And not forgetting the fact that we want to leave you with some temperatures coming in from across the country in different districts.